In this video, I'm going to show you how to get started with Redis and Python as quickly as possible. Time is short, let's jump straight in. The first thing you're going to need is a requirements.txt file to install the Python Redis client. You can see that on line 1, and on line 2 I'm installing the high Redis package. That's just a best practice from Redis themselves. It makes Redis a little bit quicker. It's completely transparent to use, so I'm going to use that. Do pip install -r requirements.txt to install those packages, and then create an app.py file. As you'd expect, I'm doing an if name is main just to hook into the startup of the program, and then I'm writing a custom function called do this. Now, before this video, I installed the Redis server on my laptop using Homebrew. So that is running on the default port localhost, of course, which is 6379. So in my do this, the first thing I do is connect to the Redis server, and then I use that Redis server to set a key value pair where the key is foo and the value is bar. Now what I do is I'm going to print that out with a 1 second sleep in between, and you'll see why in a moment, but I'm just going to print that out 10 times. And you'll also notice here that I'm getting, or trying to get, a value from the server called foo2. Now, of course, we haven't set that, so that shouldn't exist. So let's run this program and see what we get. So as expected, foo is bar, and foo2 is none, because we haven't set foo2, so we were expecting some sort of error or none value there. And that's really all there is to using Redis with Python. It's that simple. Get and set the key value pairs. However, let's dig slightly deeper. There's a lot more you can do with Redis, but I want to show one other thing, which is when you set a value, you can tell Redis to automatically expire or remove that from the cache after a certain amount of time. This is important because if you think you're going out to a database or a backend, those results aren't going to be valid forever. So you want a way for Redis to remove that value from its cache after a certain amount of time so that you can then refresh the value. So to do that, it's very, very simple. You add another parameter in here called ex equals 5. And what that says is, 5 seconds after I set the value of foo, Redis, please remove it from the cache because I know it's no longer valid. So let's save that and rerun again and watch what happens. So now you can see at the 6th second and onwards, the value of foo is now none. That's perfect. We've hit the 5 second mark and Redis knows to remove that from the cache. And what if you want to remove values in an even shorter time frame, for example, milliseconds? You can do that very easily just by changing EX to PX. And now that time is actually in milliseconds. So for example, to remove foo after 500 milliseconds, just use PX equals 500. So there you have it, the very, very basics of running Python and Redis together. But remember, as I always say, running all of this without observability is kind of pointless. So in a subsequent video, I'm going to show you how to observe Redis using OpenTelemetry. So stay tuned for that. I'll see you soon. Bye.